the question that we always ask ourselves. Who are they? Why are they here? What do they want? And would they ever harm us? You will find the answer at this episode of the Singapore Paranormal Myth.
About whether life exists beyond us is definitely a valid question. A lot of religions have studied it, a lot of science has tried to debunk it. Personally speaking, as a member of the Singapore Paranormal Investigators, I think that there might be some truth to the idea about there is life beyond us.
That's now the part where I asked Terence to shine the gun, right?
No, you were not yet. So I think that's where I took the picture. So, yeah, something like that.
Okay. You go back and go through the negative stuff.
In scientific terms, I think probably we still have a lot of research to do. But in my personal point of view, there maybe such life after death, according to one's own belief system, whatever faith you have, I think they're bound to be another kind of dimension.
Able to communicate with us. If you're able to, one blink for yes, two blink for no. Thank you so much. May I ask, are you a male or a female? If you're male, one blink. Female, two blink. What is the sound? Are you a male? One for male. So you are a female. Can I confirm that you are a female? If you are female, can you blink once?
There are certain energies which are bad, and there are certain energies which are good, right? And then there are different strengths of different energies as well. Some who might have had a horrible death might exude a lot more negative energies, and some who might have been abandoned might have a little bit more positive energies. Truth be told, we are here to just investigate the history of the place, what might have happened, and what might have caused certain energies to remain here. We try our best not to challenge the energies here, because we never know how strong or how vindictive or how evil they might be.
Okay, currently now 13th of November, Friday the 13th, commencing EVP session. The time now is 11:07. Location, Pasir Ris Suicide Tower. Are there any spirits around here who wish to communicate? We mean you no harm. We're just only here to do a simple investigation. What happened is that there's many tales and stories saying that there's any presence of any one of you around, not from this realm. So, if you do exist, can you please show us a sign? In my hand here, I'm actually holding a recorder which allows you to communicate with us. You can wish to just speak into this recorder and we can hear you. Is there anyone here? Anyone not from this realm? Are there any spirits around here who wish to communicate?
There have been people who have claimed to have sighted a lady in white walking along the banks of Sungai Api Api, which is just behind us right here. People from the HDB blocks have said they've actually seen this figure floating around the banks. And this was even featured in Incredible Tales a few years ago. There's also rumors that someone had jumped from a structure deeper inside there, and it is nicknamed as a suicide tower.
Switching to dialogue mode. So are you a male or a female? One for female, two for male. You're a female. People say that they have actually sightings seeing you around. Is that you? One for yes, two for no. Two for no. So it's not you that people see. Do you like people? Normally people come and come around here. Do you like people to make noise here?
As a paranormalist, we use a lot of tools and a lot of gadgets and a lot of equipment, one of which is what I'm holding here right now. It's an electromagnetic force reader. It actually tries to record the presence of electromagnetic interference in the environment. And when there is a certain presence or a certain, what people say as a haunting or a ghost or an apparition, this thing will let you know as to how strong that apparition is, where is it. You can actually communicate with it as well. Besides that, we also use other kinds of equipment such as motion sensors. We also use sound recording equipment to record voices that may actually not be heard by the human ear. And we also use a temperature gun, something that measures temperatures in different parts. A spike in the temperature might suggest that there might be something amiss in the energies on that side. A dip in temperature might also suggest something like that as well.
This is part of a jetty here. People came here to fishing. This river itself, I think we have two rivers. One of the river we call the Sungai Api Api. Okay. So what happened is that this river itself, it was heard that people were fishing during low tide. They went down the place, and eventually, suddenly the tide, the water tide, get high. After get high, they've been swept away by the water. So and also people who have fell into the river and been drowned at the river. So since then, a lot of stories, when people say, oh yeah, during the night, people will see certain things like somebody fell down the water and been washed away, kind of thing, and it will keep on repeating this story, you know. Certain people will see certain apparitions or certain things, so they'll inform us and say, oh, there's there's certain things we can see down here or ask us to investigate.
For people who have the third eye, from my experience with a lot of people, they would have been ostracized since young. They would have seen something and then their parents or their cousins or their siblings would say, oh, don't be ridiculous, there's nothing there. But they insist that there is something over there. And so they felt the sense of alienation between themselves and other humans, while at the same time they felt themselves to be a little bit different from other humans because they can see things that others can't. What I would like to advise them is to actually try to read up more on energies, read up more on psychic telekinesis, psychokinesis, and to get in touch with this sensitive side of theirs so that they can understand themselves better. When they understand themselves better, only then can they actually temper the way that they talk to others when they tell others that there is something or some presence in that area. One message that goes out to them, that they are not alone. There are a lot of other people in this world with their gift, and they shouldn't be too hard on themselves.
In the name of Lord Buddha, may all negativity stay at this place and never ever follow this or refill. In the name of Lord Buddha. Om Namo Buddhaya Namo Buddha. Om Namo Buddhaya Namo Buddha. Om Namo Buddhaya Namo Buddha.
Okay, this cleansing ritual is like how say to get rid of using sage to get rid of negative vibes around our body. So our team, regardless whatever religion, the sage is actually a kind of herb. It's actually a leaf. So this is actually non-religious. Normally, depending on what type of religion, I will actually invoke the good of good and light, asking all negative energies to leave the auric field. Only good and positive energy stays. At the same time, in the name of the good and light, all negative energies is supposed to stay at this moment, this place, and not follow us home.
Of course, coming to this kind of area itself, one must be also careful, because whenever you barge in into an unknown area, first thing, always remember to respect the environment. Second thing, whenever you go into an environment which you suspect that there's actually high activities of negative energies, maybe after, before leaving the place, do a self-cleansing for yourself. Because there are also superstitions. Of course, we follow folklore and superstition in Southeast Asia, saying that some attachments might be attached to you. So my advice is that maybe if you, I mean, after your escapade, or maybe after you going for your trail-seeking trip, or this going home, maybe you can use a pomelo leaf mixed with just normal mineral water. Okay, just hold it for about 5 to 10 minutes and use the leaf and just to wash your forehead and both of the shoulders itself. Because sometimes when we move into other places, places which has energies, have negative energies impregnated into the area, as we walk past, our auric field tends to get attached to this kind of negative energies. So, I mean, for spiritual safety, I suggest that everybody should do a normal cleansing before going home. So, if you're hoping to catch a glimpse of a ghost or getting yourself trailed, always remember, safety is most important. Secondly, respect the environment, and the environment will respect you. Kenneth G, Singapore Paranormal Investigators, signing out.